In this video, we're going to walk through how to set up AI agent for your brand. But first, what would you name your AI? Something simple? A human name? Or something else? Setting up your AI agent should take around an hour to be complete. And in this video, I'll be walking through the first two steps of this flywheel, which are onboard and automate. Starting with the onboard step, you'll want to treat this process similar to how you would with a live new team member. You'll need to first grant AI agent access, particularly to Shopify. You can do so by navigating into settings and clicking My Apps. Our next order of business is setting the tone of voice AI agent should use when communicating with your customers. You'll want to make sure that this matches your existing brand's tone of voice. In order to access these settings, you'll need to navigate to Automate and select AI agent. You'll land in this configuration tab from where you can choose a preset tone of voice, including a custom one where you can input your own instructions for AI agent to follow. Now that your agent has your branded tone of voice, it's time to connect some knowledge sources so it can pull relevant information to help your shoppers. There are two main brand-specific knowledge sources that AI agent relies on, one being your help center, and the other being any additional URLs you'd like to use as a supplement. If you have an existing help center, you can go ahead and select it from the dropdown. It likely already contains useful information AI agent can leverage in order to help your shoppers with brand-specific knowledge. Now you can add any public URLs you'd like to use as resources. Think of blog posts, individual FAQ pages, or anything else that might be useful. Now that your agent is equipped with brand and product knowledge, it's time to move on to the automate step of the process, starting with guidance. In the previous step, we saw that brand knowledge is sourced from help centers and other URLs. For support knowledge, AI agent relies on guidance instructions. Guidance is a response template that equips AI agent with specific instructions in which wording to use when handling particular support requests. This ensures consistent, accurate, and policy-compliant customer experience from start to finish. Navigate to the Guidance tab and select Create from Template to get started. Each guidance template allows you to instruct AI agent on how it should behave in particular support requests. You'll notice that each guidance includes instructions which are written in plain language. This cancel order example details what AI agent should do if a customer asks to cancel or edit an order. Edit these instructions in order to match your company's workflow, processes, and policy needs. Once you've created your first guidance, you'll be able to control whether it's enabled or disabled from a toggle. Now that your agent has instructions for how to handle specific support requests, it's time to enable some actions, effectively doubling the number of email tickets AI agent is able to resolve on average. Head over to the Actions tab and select a pre-built native action to get started. Pre-built actions are ready to go out of the box. You still have the option to customize input variables and conditions to further your control over this action. After creating your first action, you can toggle them on or off at any time from the Actions tab. Ready to see your agent in action? Head over to the Test tab for a controlled environment where you can test your AI agent's configuration. Within this chat instance, you can pose as either a new or existing customer, and you can submit test inquiries to see how your AI agent responds. Below each message from AI agent, you can see the knowledge sources used to formulate the response. And that does it. We just set up AI agent. Once live, AI agent will automatically begin handling any tickets coming through the designated email integration you set within the configuration tab. You can monitor any tickets AI agent is handling or processing within the dedicated views.